Hello viewers, yo, welcome back to my channel. I still remain Jadsax, the saxophone instructor and coach right here in this channel. Okay, today I'm going to teach you 5 ways to memorize sax songs. If you are a saxophone player, I'm going to show you 5 ways to memorize songs as a saxophone player. Okay, now for intensive one-on-one saxophone training course program, you can reach me via this number, okay? +234 81 44 058 513. I repeat again, +234 81 44 058 513. All right, now straight to the business of the day. I said I'm gonna give you 5 ways to memorize saxophone songs, or 5 ways to memorize songs as a saxophone player. Number one, first, I always advise saxophonists is to identify the key of the song. Remember, I said number one is to identify the key of the song. Now, identifying the key of the song is not just enough. Now, what do you need to do with the key of the song? That's where we're going to talk on now. Practice the scale associated with the key of the song and practice it before learning the tune. Okay? I said, practice the scale associated with the key of the song and practice it before learning the tune. Commit the scale to memory so that it becomes second nature. Yeah. I repeat, commit the scale to memory so that it becomes your second nature. This will make learning the song so much easier. Why is this important? This is important because many times I've come to discover that as a saxophonist, you might choose to play on a particular key now, and you find out that you're already on another key. Yes, it's never a big deal. What you need to do in such cases is what I'm talking about now. Make sure you commit the scale to memory so that it becomes your second nature. This will make learning the songs so much easier. And number two, break it down. Yes. You can't just take a piece and say you want to score or you want to memorize the song or the piece in just a moment. No. Okay? Now, break it down. Now, this is what you're going to do when I said we should break it down. I mean, you should divide the song into smaller sections and tackle each part individually. Breaking it down implies you dividing the song or the piece into smaller sections and tackle each part individually. Okay, now start with the chorus or the main melody, then work your way through the verses and bridge. Once you've mastered each section, put them together to play the song in its entirety. Alright? Now, what is important on this second point is for you to make sure you divide the song or the musical piece into sections. Don't rush it. And master it separately. Alright? If you are starting with the chorus, start with the chorus. Master the chorus very well. If you are starting with the verse, or you are working on the bridge, master each of the sections separately. That's the second part. Now, the third thing you need to do in order for you to memorize any musical piece or any song as a saxophonist or any other musical instrumentalist out there is repetition. Yes. Number three, the third point is repetition. Practice playing each session repeatedly until it becomes ingrained in your memory. Focus on playing it slowly and accurately at first, then gradually increasing the tempo as you become more comfortable with the notes and rhythms. I'm going to take this point again on repetition. I said you should practice playing the sessions repeatedly until it becomes ingrained in your memory. Focus on playing it slowly and accurately. You don't need to rush anything. Slowly and accurately. Alright, at first. Now, you can now gradually start to increase the tempo as you become more comfortable with the notes and rhythms. Number four, use mnemonics. Alright, now this is what I mean when I'm talking on this particular point. You're going to create mnemonic device or visual clues to help you remember the sequence of notes and rhythm in the song. For example, you could create a phrase where each word corresponds to a note or rhythm in the melody, perhaps even the lyrics. Okay, and number five, which is very important, record and listen. Okay, record yourself playing the song and listen back to identify areas that need improvement. Pay attention to your phrasings, dynamics, and overall interpretation of the music. Hearing yourself play can help reinforce your memory of the song and identify areas for further practice. So recording yourself and listening to yourself will go a long way to help you to memorize any musical piece of your choice or any song given to you to score as a saxophone player. Alright, if you are eager to dive deeper and explore how to apply these techniques further, yes, you can schedule a session with me. Yes, alright, or enroll for the intensive one-on-one saxophone training course. I'm not just going to be teaching you saxophones. I'm going to be teaching you some techniques that are very relevant to you as a saxophone player. And I'm going to be sharing some ideas with you. Okay, so these are some of the things that we do in our intensive saxophone training sessions. All right, you're going to learn a lot of things and learn even from my experience. Experience, as they say, is the best teacher. Yes, so there are a whole lot of things for you to know by the time you enroll into the intensive one-on-one saxophone training course program with me at Juma Jadsax International Music Academy. Okay, I repeat again the phone number through which you can reach me. It is +234 81 44 058 513. I'm going to take it again, +234 81 44 058 513. Thank you for watching. Keep learning and keep tuning to this channel. Bye for now.